Hello friends, how are you? Today I have a very interesting topic, that is Cinematography Act 1952. Actually this topic is very vast, and today under this topic there are some bodies that is on central level and the regional level. I will discuss about them, their duties, functions, meetings and the certificates which are issued by them. And all these important points, their objectives and aims, and what steps they take to grant the certificates of the films. So all these points I will discuss about in a long way. So kindly be with me. One by one, I will discuss about them. So first of all, we should understand this: what is censorship? Actually, if we talk about the censorship according to the dictionary meaning, so we will find that prohibitions or suppressions of any kind or any part of the books, papers and films which is not acceptable and which is a threat, which pose a threat to the society and to the security. So that is all about the censorship as per the dictionary meanings. But in other terms, if we talk about the censorship, so censorship is just like the public exhibitions or a film which where the content of the film is okay and it is not objectionable and it is ready to be broadcasted for the public exhibitions. Meet it is all for the general public and where no such objectionable point is to be taken. So that is the censorship. But you know very well that when the film is made, so there are some contents where contents are objectionable, and to check all these contents, there are some bodies which they are at central level as well as the regional levels working, and they thoroughly examines all the contents, and if these contents are removed and or modified or changed, then the film owner will get the certificates, and he has the right to telecast that. So this is all about the censorship. So now the next step is that under the Cinematography Act 1952, first of all I will discuss about the censor board. Actually there is a censor board which has been constituted under the Cinematography Act 1952. This is the main regulating body and this is mainly functions at the central level. There are also the advisory boards, that is also known as the advisory panels. Actually these panels are also established constituted at the regional levels, and as you know very well that there are seven regions where the panels have been working, just like New Delhi, Hyderabad, Trivandrum, Kolkata, Bangalore and Chennai. All these cities these panels have been working. Okay, what is the role of these panels is that these panels checks the content of the films, and after going through and after checking thoroughly of the content of the film, they produce the certificates. So right now I will try to discuss about the right to censorship under the Indian constitutions. As you know very well that right to freedom and right to press is impliedly merged in the right to freedom under Article 19 sub clause 1, and right to freedom also includes right to censorship. So whenever we talk about the right to freedom, right of press, right of censorship is already included there. But as you know very well, right to freedom is not absolute. It is subjected to certain restrictions and there are some limitations on them. Just like matters which are against the public policies, sovereignty, integrity and public morals and foreign policies, there are some limitations and restrictions over the right to freedom or right to press. The same is with the censorship. Right to censorship. because when the film is made, so there are some content which are not suitable for all the sections of the society or for all age groups. So, so in order to check all these things, there are the groups which are working at central level. That is censor board, which works at central level, which is known as Central Board of Film Certifications. Central Board of Film Certifications is at central level, and advisory boards, which is also known as the advisory body, these bodies are working at state levels, and there are 7 advisory bodies in India currently. The function of the censor board or advisory body is that once any film comes to the censor board, there are 2 points. It gives sanctions to the films, means the film is ready to be public exhibitions, unrestricted exhibitions, means it is all for general public. And the second point is that the censor board gives the sanction. Sanction means grant the certificate of the film, but it is restricted to adult or some age groups persons. So the most important point is that censor board has to go thoroughly examine all the contents, visual scenes which have been used in the films, and if they require any changes or modifications, so after changes and modifications they give the sanctions. And sometimes it also happens censor boards also, means CBFC, Central Boards of Film Certifications, also directs the filmmakers to change or modify some scenes and some content of the movie which has already been sanctioned. So when all the scenes which are recommended by them have been changed fully, and they are again put to the censor board, and censor board again examined. If censor board is fully satisfied, then it gives green signals and film is to be telecasted. But if if censor board is not satisfied, and if it denies to a sanction, it means that the movie is not at all for the public viewing. So there are 4 types of certificates. So this was all about the functions of the censor boards. So if we try to know how many types of certificates which are issued by the censor boards, so there are 4 types of certificates. So first type of certificate, which is known as universal, and which stands for U, which means which is denoted by U, U alphabet. So universal means it means that the censor board has given the sanctions to that film which is eligible, which is used for unrestricted exhibitions, means which is used for public viewing at large, and it means it is suitable for all kinds or all sections or all age groups of the public. And second kind of film certificate is a universal, is under parental guardian, UNDRPARENTIL, and guidance, which is denoted by UA. It means that the film is appropriate for all kinds of people, all sections and all age groups, but in the interest of the children who are below the age of 12 years, the theme of the movie is not most appropriate without the guidance of their parents. So this is all about the second type of the film certificate. Now the third type of film certificate is adult, which is denoted by A alphabet. It means that the censor board has given the sanctions of that film, which is restricted to the adults only who are at the age of above 18 years, and that film is restricted to the adult. Other than the adults, no one can see that film. And the fourth kind of film certificate, which is known as the special classes of person, which is denoted by S. It means the It means that the film is relating to a particular professions, and the film is used for the special class. Special class does not mean here that it is relating to any disability or something. Special class means it is relating to any professional. It is relating to any profession, just like doctors. Means the film is used for tutorial purpose of the doctors. So there are four types of film certificates which I have just told you. Now the main objective of the censor board. What are the main objective of the censor board? And these objectives have been mentioned under the SEMO, and these are the main objectives. These are mentioned under the Cinematography Act 1952. The first objective is that censor board has to ensure. The first objective is that censor board has to ensure that the medium of the content of the movie is responsible for society. Mean whatever content the film is having, that is responsible for the society. The second objective of the censor board is that there should be a sensitivity and there should be a standard of the society. Mean content or scene which are used in the movies, that should maintain the standard of the society. The third objective is that the scenes which are used in the movies, they will promote the clean and healthy environment for the society. And fourth objective is the movie which and fourth objective is the movies which are the scenes which are used, that should be according to the standard of the cinema. Means because the filmmakers, director, producers and distributors, they know the standard of the cinemas, so film should be according to the standard of the cinemas. So there are the four objective, and one more is objective which right now I am forgetting. I will tell you later. These are the four objectives, and in pursuance of these four objectives, censor board has to take some steps while considering and while examining the content of the movies. So there are five steps censor board has to take care while examining the content of the movies. So first step is that whatever anti-social activities or anti-social subjects are used, and violent and scenes which are indulge in violence, they are used, the censor board has to put limitations on them, and censor board has to keep restrictions over them. The second step censor board has to take, that is whatever scenes which are being shown that is abusive to the children, abusive to the mentally or physically handicapped people, abusive to the animals, so that should not be acceptable because they promote for the commissions of the crime. And the third point is that censor board has to keep in mind, which is that the criminals which are being shown in the movies, they are what types of criminals, and is there any way they should promote the commission of crimes for the children? And the fourth point is that censor board has to keep in mind that that pointless scenes and violent scenes which are promoting entertainment, that should be kept away from the movies. And the fifth point is that that degrading of women, some scenes which are having in that degrading of women, disrespecting of women and dual meanings, and which may create bad impacts over the society, so that should be kept away from such contents. So all these steps have to be taken by the censor boards at the central level or at the regional levels. So till now I have discussed about the Cinematography Act 1952 and what is censorship And after the censorship means a right to censorship under the Indian constitutions and restrictions and limitations over them and functions of the and censor boards at the central level and advisory panel or advisory board as the at the regional level and their functions, their main objectives which are mentioned under the Act 1952. And what steps have to be kept in mind by the censor board while examining the content of the movies. So all these things I have discussed, I mean, till now. And now further I will discuss about the terms of the office of the censor board. As you know very well, chairmen and members, they are appointed by the central government. They are appointed by the central government and their tenure of the office is 3 years. I mean, they cannot exceed for 3 years. And constitutions of the advisory boards of the regional level, that is the heading. And a central government is empowered to constitute the advisory board. Advisory board is also known as the advisory panel at the regional level. So central government has the power to appoint them, and central government is also empowered to appoint certain numbers of chairmen and members at each advisory body in regional level. Means there are not fixed numbers of chairmen and members on in advisory body. Central government is at its discretion. And the third point is that but while appointing the chairman and members of the advisory board, central government is very much required to discuss, and central government has to consult with the center board. Means central government has to consult with the central board of film certifications before appointing the chairman and members for the advisory panels. And tenure of the advisory panels, the members and the chairmen, they are appointed only for 2 years. If any member or chairman is at the time of retirement, so after retirement, they are eligible for the reappointment. So central government is also empowered to remove them or to dismiss them before completion of the 2 years on the justified grounds, only after giving the opportunities of being heard. Central government is also empowered to make any chairman or member of the advisory boards, just like chief executive officers, additional officers, and additional regional officers, assistant regional officers, or any regional officers at its thing fits. It is on the discretion of the on the central government. So duties of the censor board, which duties of the censor board is also very important. Actually, censor board has to provide the reports to the central governments. This report also contains the work which has been done by the censor board during the preceding financial years, and the report should also contain the detailed analytical reports of the recent trends which are related to the film industry. It means what are the new trends which are going on in the film industry, that should also be put in the reports. Records, registers, and accounts are to be maintained as per the prescribed manner by the censor board, and the censor board has to review all the work which are done by the regional officials, and also review the work done by the each members of the advisory panels. So this is about the duties of the censor board. So now we discuss about the meeting. So the chairman of the censor board is empowered to call the meetings. The meeting should be met at every quarter, but if there are any extraordinary meeting, so chairman is empowered to call it at his discretion. Means it is the discretion of the chairman to call at any time if there is very urgent or extraordinary meetings, and the delays of the meetings, it adds the discretion of the chairman. Chairman is empowered to decide where the meeting is to be held. So we have discussed about the meetings. So notice of the meetings, the chairman is empowered to provide the 21 days prior notice to all the members of the board, and if there is very urgent meeting, then 3 days prior notice to be given to all the members of the boards by chairman. So this is all about the notice of the meeting. So now we discuss about the duties, meetings and notice of the meetings. So right now we will discuss about the applications for the exhibitions of films. It means when the film has been completed, then the filmmaker, producer or director, they will make the applications to the censor board to thoroughly examine their films and give the certificate and provide them the certificate. Granting certificate, you can say that censor board grant this means grant them or given them permission to telecast them. So for this applicant has to make a written application in writing, which is as per the prescribed manner, which is schedule second, and which is mentioned under the schedule second under the Cinematography Act 1952. And if the content of the application is neither in English language or nor in any Indian language, then applicant is very much required to provide the 8 printed copies of translation in English or Hindi. So the process of certification, that is the last point which I am going to discuss with you. The process of the certification is also very very unique, because under the process of the certifications there are two committees. First is examining committee and second is reviewing committee. So for getting these certificates, first of all, examining committee is empowered to go thoroughly and examine the content of the movies, whatever the according to examining committees, if there are some changes which are to be done and there are some modifications which are to be made, so examining committee can ask the filmmakers to modify or change that, and whatever recommendations, suggestions and final statements examining committee will give, will say, then filmmakers and if the filmmakers is not satisfied with the order of the examining committee, so they can approach to the review committee. Review committee will review the order given by the examining committee, and if they also satisfied, so they may pass the order in favor of the examining committee, or they may set aside or they may modify the order. But if the applicant or filmmaker is still not satisfied,